I'm Şerefcan and this is my introduction to algorithm project in MATLAB. The main idea of this project is implement and visualize some basic algorithms. These are the algorithms that I use in this application. This LinkedIn button will send you to my LinkedIn account. When you click Gmail button, there's a new page will come up on your screen. You need to write your name and email address. After that, the only thing that you need to do is write your text messages to send your feedbacks. After that, you need to click send button to send your text message. This ask me button is a kind of a little information about me. Also, my application has a voice assistant. Some basic things, some information messages, some error messages are done by voice assistant, just like that.
My name is Serafkan Helvakoglu.
As you can see, some basic things are done by voice assistant in this application. This YouTube button will send you our department's YouTube account, and this button will send you our school's webpage. As you can see, these are the algorithms that I use. Each of these information buttons will send you web pages that have detailed explanations about these algorithms, such as flowchart and pseudocodes or something like that. And these main buttons has text messages inside of them. These text messages has two different texts. The first one is the main idea behind these algorithms, and the second one is helpful to use this application, how this application works, which button does what work, or kind of things. And each buttons has different algorithm techniques inside of them. Our first algorithm is sorting algorithm. First, to visualize sorting method, we need to create a random array. To do this, we can arrange array size and maximum number. As you can see, array size and maximum number can be changed by clicking these buttons. You can change the range of array size and maximum number. After that, you need to choose a repeated number or non-repeated number in your array. These are obligated to choose one of them. If you choose both of them, you will get an error message by voice assistant. And if you are not choose any of them, you will get again an error message from voice assistant like that.
You should choose whether there will be repeated numbers in your sequence or not.
As you can see, you need to choose only one of them. Also, you can choose seed and seed constant in here. This is not obligated. It's just up to you to use it or not. Also, there is default value button in here. If you click this, the default value is set in the screen. After that, we need to click generate random array button.
The random array is created.
After that, the random array will come on your screen. As you can see, we have 12 different sorting methods. If you want, we can try merge sort. In here, you can arrange the speed of the sorting process. This is the merge sort, and it uses divide and conquer method in the sorting process. Also, after it's done, you will get a message.
Merge sort is complete.
Just like that. There is one more different way to create your array. You need to write, you can create your own array by writing your numbers. After that, you need to click generate own array.
Is created.
And then your array is going to be created in here. And also you can add number to the sequence like that.
The number added.
As you can see, also you can get your array from an Excel file, and also you can save your sorted array as a Excel file. After that, if you want to clean the app, you need to click clear button.
Application cleared.
Also, there's a time comparison in here. Time comparison is compare the sorting algorithms times. First, we can also again arrange the indexes of the array number, iteration index, and maximum number. We can change them by clicking these buttons. Let's click default values. After that, you can also again choose seed value and seed constant. And after that, you can whatever click all algorithms, or you can choose some of these algorithms and click compare chosen algorithms. And then the graph of this merge sort and quick sort time comparison will come here. Also, you can save this graph as an image. Our second algorithm is Fibonacci. It's basic Fibonacci sequence. First, you need to choose your array size. Then you need to write number that you want to find. And after that, you need
the
to click find
found.
Button. After that, the button, the numbers index will come to your screen. Also, you can save this Fibonacci sequence as an Excel file. And if you wanna clear this up, you need to click clear button. And also, again, you can arrange the limits of the array size by clicking these buttons. Also, there's a golden ratio button in here. By clicking this draw golden ratio button, you can see the division of the numbers is not going is stable after some point. Our third algorithm is binary search. Just like sorting methods, you need to arrange array size and maximum number. We can just click
default values.
Values
are set.
And after that, again, we need to obligate to choose one of these options, non-repeated or repeated number. Also, we can choose seed number and seed constant. And after that, we need to click generate random array button.
The random array is created.
The array will created in here. Again, we choose seed value. So
the
whenever
random
I
array is created.
Click this generate random array button, the unsorted array will not going to change because I click seed and I choose the seed constant. After that, I need to sort this array by just clicking the sort button. And then I need to enter the number that I want to find. Let's write 21. Then I need to click find button.
The number is found.
And then the number is going to be found in here. Also, if I write a number that not exists in the array, let's try this.
The number that you're looking for is not in the array. Please try again.
As you can see, a voice assistant will warn you about the array is not in the array. The number is not in the array. Also, you can again create your own array by writing numbers in here. And also, again, you can add any number to your unsorted array. And also, you can get array from Excel. And the save Excel file is saving the sorted array, not unsorted one. If you click this, the sorted array will save as an Excel file. Our fourth algorithm is matrix multiplication. First, you need to enter row and column sizes of matrix 1 and matrix 2, or you can easily just click
default
values.
Are set.
As you can see, the values are set. After that, you need to choose the maximum number in this matrices has. Also, you can again change the limits of the maximum number. Then you need to click create matrices.
Matrices are created.
And then the matrices will be created in here. After that, you need to choose which operation that you want to do on these matrices. Multiplication, divisions, addition and subtraction.
Matrices are multiplied.
As you can see, the result matrix will come up in here. Also, again, the basic rule of this matrix multiplication, the column size of matrix 1 must be equal to the row size of matrix 2. If it's not equal, let's first clear the app.
Application is cleared.
After that, let's set
default
values.
Values are set.
And then change this. Then create matrices in here.
Matrices are created.
And if we click matrix multiplication button,
these matrices are not proper to multiply.
As you can
Matrices
see,
are multiplied.
The error message will come by voice assistant. Also, you can get matrix each matrices by using an Excel file, and you can save your result matrix as an Excel file too. Our last algorithm is randomized selection. First, again, you need to create a random array. You can change your array size and maximum number limits by just clicking these buttons. Click default values.
Values are set.
After that, again, you need to obligate it to choose repeated or non-repeated options. If you are going to choose both of them, you will get an error message. If you are not choose any of them, you will get a error message again. And you can also choose seed and seed constant. After this arrangement, you need to click generate random array button.
The random array is created.
After that, you need to enter which smallest number that you want to find in the array. Let's click 4.
The number is found.
After that, the fourth smallest element in the array is 10, which row is in here. Also, you can again create your own array in here, just like typing like that. And also, you can add your unsorted array as a number. As you can see, these are the all algorithms that I use in my application. Thank you for watching.